Therefore, do not worry about tomorrow, for tomorrow will worry about itself. Each day has enough trouble of its own. Matthew, the 6th chapter and the 34th verse. There are 2 days in the week upon which and about which I never worry. 2 carefree days kept sacredly free from fear and apprehension. One of these days is yesterday. Yesterday, with its cares and frets, all its pains and aches, all its faults, mistakes, and blunders, has passed forever beyond my recall. I cannot undo an act that I wrought, nor unsay a word that I said. All that it holds of my life, of wrong, regret, and sorrow, is in the hands of the mighty love that can bring honey out of the rock and sweetest waters out of the bitterest desert. Save for the beautiful memories, sweet and tender, that linger like the perfume of roses in the heart of that day that is gone. I have nothing to do with yesterday. It was mine. It is God's. And the other day I do not worry about is tomorrow. Tomorrow, with all its possible adversities, its burdens, its peril, its large promise and poor performance, its failures and mistakes, is as far beyond my mastery as its dead sister yesterday. It is a day of God's. Its sun will rise in roseate splendor, or behind a mask of weeping clouds, but it will rise. Until then, the same love and patience that held yesterday holds tomorrow, except for the star of hope that gleams forever on the brow of tomorrow, shining with tender promise into the heart of today. I have no possession in that unborn day of grace. All else is in the safe keeping of the infinite love that is higher than the stars, wider than the skies, deeper than the seas. Tomorrow is God's day. It will be mine. There is left for myself then but one day in the week. Today. Any man can fight the battles of today. Any woman can carry the burdens of just one day. Any man can resist the temptation of today. Oh, my brothers and sisters, it is when we willfully add the burdens of those 2 awful eternities, yesterday and tomorrow, much burden as the only mighty God can sustain, that we break down. It isn't the experience of the day that drives men crazy. It is the remorse for something that happened yesterday, or the dread of what tomorrow may disclose. These are God's days. Leave them with Him. Therefore, I think and I do and I journey, but one day at a time. That is the easy way. That is man's day. Dutifully, I run my course and work my appointed task on the day of ours. God, the Almighty and the All-Loving, takes care of yesterday and tomorrow. But Lord, tomorrow? Did I not die for Thee? Do I not live for Thee? Leave me tomorrow. Tomorrow is God's secret, but today is yours to live. All the tomorrows of our lives have to pass him before they can go to us. I heard a voice at evening softly say, "Bear not thy yesterday into tomorrow, nor load this week with last week's sorrow. Lift all thy burden as they come, nor try to weigh the present with the by and by. One step, then another. Take thy way, live by the day."
Jesus said, "Here I stand, won't you please let me in?" And you said, "I will tomorrow." Jesus said, "I am he who supplies all your needs." And you said, "I know, but tomorrow, ooh, tomorrow, I'll give my life tomorrow. I thought about today, but it's so much easier to say tomorrow. Who promised you tomorrow? Better choose the Lord today, for tomorrow very well might be too late." Jesus said, "Here I stand, won't you please take my hand?" And you said, "I will." "I am he who supplies all your needs." And you say, "I know, but tomorrow, oh, tomorrow, I'll give my life tomorrow. I thought about today, oh, but so much easier. Give your life.